defense scuffling and being able to run a beat now. What is the SD to practice to address it and to shore it up?
We just keep working on getting good shots. Today we, you know, we didn't have a lot of bodies again, so it was more, you know, working on some of the fundamentals, making extra passes, doing your work early offensively as far as setting people up before you come off screen, setting screens once you get in the paint, you know, having coaches out there clog up the middle and then making another extra pass. So I think last night in the game when we shared the ball and put pressure on them, we got great looks. We didn't do, you know, we didn't knock them down like we should, but we will if we continue to get more of those type of shots. We had way too many possessions though where we tried to do it by ourselves, and those are the, you know, that's a good defense stuff to score a lot of when we play like this.
Talk a lot about trusting the pass. How do you get him to do that consistently even when
it's just the right way to play. You gotta trust your teammates now. You know, we're not gonna win if we don't trust our, you know, our teammates to make the right plays and make those shots. And whether the shots go in or not, you know, that's not the important thing. The important thing is that we make that play.
Have you noticed a difference at all between this year and last with the young guys in terms of situations like this where they're playing against hard competition? This year, the consequences for losing are much bigger. This makes a lot more impact and stakes.
And now, what's the question?
Have you seen a difference in how they handle it, how they react?
Yeah, they seem like they like it. They seem like they're into it, really. And you know, they talk about it as a group. You know, where we're at, what we're trying to do. I think for the most part, it keeps them sharper than we were at times last year.
How do you prevent sort of the frustration that comes? Because they're still where they are in their development. Even if the wins matter more, there's still certain things they may or may not be able to do. How do you prevent them from getting frustrated when things don't go well?
Frustration's part of it. Okay. I mean, I think every one of us is frustrated last night. And you do your best to move forward today. You know, holding on to that frustration, you can use it for to keep an edge going into tomorrow's game. But coming in today's practice is like, all right, you know, what do we have to do to get better? Where were the mistakes at? Where do we have slippage at? And then that's what we show in the film room. And we come out here and work on those. And constantly, with frustration or not, we're trying to move forward.
The Knicks came to LA on, I think, a 9-game losing streak.
Yeah.
And, you know, go up 17 in the first quarter, Cavs 12-game losing streak.
Yeah.
Will there be any sort of reference?
Absolutely. We got to learn from our past. Learn from the mistakes we made. And, you know, Cleveland's very capable, like every team in the NBA. I know they've lost a lot in a row, but there's games. I started watching scout work on them last night. You know, they jumped out on New Orleans early, and they're knocking down threes. And, you know, even the Houston game, they started that game all right before they got. So they're very capable of playing. And if we have that same mentality we did against the Knicks, then there's no reason they can't beat us. So hopefully, and I expect us to learn from that, but yeah, we'll reference that.
Obviously, Mitchell and Gobert are very, very difficult to figure out how to defend. But last night, JaVale said after the game that he thought you guys should have changed up your coverages earlier in the game. Did you hear that? Did you guys have any conversation about that, or kind of?
Yeah, we talked about that.
Okay. Is that an okay perspective for him?
Yeah, for sure. The perspective is, you know, I'm never a big fan of telling you guys that stuff, but we showed film on it, and the deep drop is one of our coverages, and when we're playing it the way we should, we're actually really good in our deep drop. It, you know, between some of the bigs we have, JaVale, Zoo, Tyson, we clog up that paint. We got long perimeter guards to get the back pressure, so it's one of our better coverages. We didn't do it great last night, but you know, they are still defensively. They shot a low percentage, and you know, we could have done a much better job. But yeah, we talked about it.
Would you, when you looked at it, was he right in some ways, or in terms of his evaluation?
Well, the way that we were playing it, yeah. But to us as a coaching staff, it's always let's just play our coverage better.
Right.
You know what I mean? Let's do a better job of what we, you know, we historically, you know, done pretty well this year. But you know, we switched the coverage up, and we had some success with our switching. But it's move forward, get better.
Making you guys were short on bodies today, other than Rondo and LeBron.
We sent two of the young guys down to the G League. Tyson, we're not gonna have to do much in these type of days. I think we had nine bodies. 5-on-5 is 10, so.
Did you go to Arizona?
I did go there, and I graduated.
With Beasley, was it just a scare yesterday with the camera?
Yeah.
Is he good to go for it?
He was full of gold.
Wow, they got two hands, right?
Technically has two hands. His one hand is way more dominant than the other.
As a coach, how do you look at this new emphasis in shoe fashion with the NBA rule change, a lot of players wear whatever they want to wear?
I don't. I have the Bleacher Report app, and they send me dings, and anytime I look at it and it's a shoe thing, I shut my app down and get upset that they alerted me to let me know someone's wearing a different type of shoes.
You got John Elliott's on, and those are coveted sneakers.
I was told that when LeBron gave these to everybody, and they're like, "Are you wearing those?" And I was like, "Yeah, they're shoes." those are like, you got to keep those. Shoes are meant to be worn. They're very comfortable. I enjoy wearing them, but I don't think much of it.